along to other talented people in our orchestra. We would like to present for you a piece called Andante and Variations. The composer, Pedro Bottesini, was a guitar and clarinet playing father of one of the more famous Giovanni Bottesini. I need to work on my head. The son, who he was a famous double bass virtuoso. He was more famous than his father, but his father wrote this piece. Very little is known about the elder Bottesini, but he lived in the early 19th century in northern Italy. That much we do know. His work before us tonight, written for clarinet, flute, and string quartet, is an opening Andante, followed by a new theme, and then with four variations after that. So if we pause, that's not the end until I lower the baton. So you'll know when it's the end. Our clarinet soloist tonight is Eileen Schaeffers, a name well known to many of you. They've lived here for a long time. I'd like to read a very little bit about Eileen because she's very modest and she doesn't write much about herself. But she did say this, after hearing Henry Cuesta, some of you know who that is, playing on Lawrence Welk, Eileen made the all-important decision to play clarinet in the fifth grade band. During her high school years, she played in three state solo contests and an all-state and all-American band. Later, she became a music major at the U of O, playing in several ensembles there. Now, she enjoys playing in the community band, community orchestra, and the Happy Five Polka Band. Does indeed sound happy. If you were at the Bay Area Concert Band concert two Thursdays ago, seems like a long time ago, Eileen was prominently featured with a microphone to her clarinet playing a tribute to Artie Shaw in the jazz style. Tonight she's going to be showing her versatility by playing in the very classical style of Pietro Bottesini. That's our clarinet soloist. We have a flute soloist as well, Heidi Conley, whose name unfortunately is left out of our orchestra personnel in your program. A gremlin got into the printer's office and printed out last year's flute player instead. So Heidi is the one that's here, and we are very, very glad of that. Heidi, the most notable thing about her career is how she started playing at age 5 and then stopped playing for almost 30 years before picking up the flute again, a little over 2 years ago. Heidi graduated at Harvard University with a performance degree. Being in the same class with Yo-Yo Ma, the world-renowned cellist, was a daunting situation, to say the least. After her degree, she headed for New York City, where she taught, played chamber music, and performed as much as possible, on stage as well as in restaurants and at weddings. What's a wedding without a great flute player, is what I always say, right? Her music career was cut short, however, after developing a challenging problem with her jaw. You know, I don't ever understand why it is that musicians go deaf and have problems with the parts of their bodies they need for music. Artists go blind. I think it's just the nature of the world around us, but we have to overcome those things, and Heidi did. And just this part is familiar too, isn't it, Joanne, with your story a couple months ago. Heidi raised a family and worked at a couple of different careers after that, primarily corporate training and then in her own business, Harvard Girl Word Services, as an editor, book designer, and self-publishing consultant. When a close friend suggested she buy another flute, she demurred, saying, "Why would I ever do that? There's no way I'll ever be able to play again." But she couldn't get the idea out of her head, and eventually acquiesced. Now, even though her fingers will never work quite the way they used to, Heidi can't believe she's capable of playing what she is playing, and wonders how she ever lived without the instrument that feels as if it was attached to her body since she was born. Tonight, she's playing on a new instrument, an instrument she purchased in February, a special James Galway model. And she says, it's like having Heidi in a flute. I will never stop playing again. So I present to you Heidi and Eileen.